Okay, today we're done with our field work and we're going to look at exporting our GPS data as an ASCII file. So let's take a look at our points. Under our points, we see we have 790 points in this job. We can also take a look at our map screen, and under our map screen here, we can get a pretty good idea as to where these points are and what they look like. So let's just take a look at the point IDs only. And you'll see here we have a pretty busy file with a lot of centerline points and some pad points, that type of stuff. But these are the points we're going to be exporting. So from our main file tab, let's go to number 7, Import Export. And this time we're going to choose Export ASCII File. When we do, it asks us what type of file we want to export. Here we have several different options, including KML for Google Earth and some other file types that we can use in different Carlson softwares and other softwares available. But we're going to say user defined because we want to export an ASCII or a text file. And we're going to do it in the point ID. It's going to be comma delimited north, east, comma delimited elevation, comma description. We could choose space or tab delimited or some other, but the most common is northern, easting, elevation, and comma delimited. We also have the options that we could change some of this, but this is our most common format, so we're going to stay here. If we had point notes or attributes, we could also export those as part of our export process. We can choose a range of points. So in this case, maybe we only want to export point number 200 through 225 because that's all we collected today. And our precision on these, we can choose whichever precision we prefer. We'll go 3 decimal places just for the fun of it. Note, this does not round it when you choose this. It just truncates at the particular decimal place that you choose. So we're going to go ahead and export that. It asks us to give it a name, and we're going to go ahead and call it tutorial.txt, and it's going to be stored, and pay close attention to this, the passage path that it's stored under, because this is where you're going to need to grab it to when you hook up with ActiveSync or with Windows Mobile Center to move it back to your office. In this case, you see where it's going to be stored here. I could go up or down here and find a different place to store it if I chose. And let's go ahead. I'm going to put it on my desktop. I'm going to do is it a .txt file. I could do it as an ASCII. And you'll notice down at the bottom here, when I do that, the extension changes. So again, pay attention to that so you know what you're exporting. Let's go ahead and export those points. Very quickly, it says it's done. If at this point I go ahead and look at my desktop on my computer, I can find those particular files and I can open them up. And there they are in an ASCII format, openable in Notepad. You could also open them in Excel or any other file manner of you're choosing to open your file, probably directly into your CAD software. I hope you find this helpful, and thank you very much for your time.